When you're just getting started with Photoshop, it's helpful to understand the workspace right from the beginning. Knowing how to work with the workspace elements and how to zoom and pan around your image will make it much easier to work on your creative projects. My name is Rob de Winter, an Adobe certified instructor, author and designer from the Netherlands, and in this video I'll guide you through the essential parts of the Photoshop interface. In the center of your screen, you'll find the document window. This is where you edit your images. Think of it as the main canvas for all your editing. On the right side of the workspace, you'll find various panels like layers and properties. These panels allow you to manage and modify different parts of your project. You can switch between panels in a group by clicking their tabs. For example, you can click the swatches panel to open your color swatches, and if you want to return to the color panel, just click on its tab again. If you need a panel that isn't currently visible, you can open it by going to Window in the menu bar and selecting the panel you need. For instance, if you are looking for the Brushes panel, you can go to Window and then to Brushes to make it appear. This way, you always have access to the panels that are most useful for your project. You can also move or even close panels. If you did that, you can always restore the workspace to its default layout. Just click on the Workspace button in the upper right corner and click Reset Essentials. Now let's go to the left side of the screen, where you'll see the toolbar. This is where you find all the tools needed for tasks. For example, you can use tools for painting, making selections, or navigating around your canvas. If you're not sure what a tool does, hover over it to see a tooltip with more information. Many tools in Photoshop are grouped together. You can recognize a tool group by the small triangle in the bottom right corner of the tool icon. To view and access the tools in a group, click and hold the tool icon. To use a particular tool, just click on it. Then, above your document window, you'll find the options bar. When you select a tool in the toolbar, the options bar will show settings specific to that tool. For example, when you click on the selection brush, you can change its size and other settings here. Each tool has different options that will appear when you select that tool. Now let's take a look at the contextual task bar, which is a dynamic, floating menu that presents the most relevant next steps in your workflow. For instance, if you're working with text, you'll see options like font and font size, while drawing a shape will show options like fill color, and stroke width. Now we've covered the most important elements of the Photoshop workspace, let's move on to the basics of navigating your image. You'll often need to zoom in and zoom out to get a closer look at details and work more precisely. To zoom in and zoom out, select the zoom tool from the toolbar. Position the zoom tool on the area where you want to zoom in, for example on this girl, and then click and immediately drag to the right to zoom in, or drag to the left to zoom out. Let's now click and drag to the right to zoom in again on this hot air balloon. Now that we're zoomed in, it would be very helpful to pan around to see and work on other areas of the image. To do this, select the hand tool from the toolbar, and then click and drag to move around the image. Now you've learned the basics of navigating the Photoshop workspace, I hope you feel more comfortable navigating your images. Again, my name is Rob de Winter, and I look forward to seeing you in more Adobe videos.